His eyes may not be dull, right? It may be a squint, it may not be a one eye. The name may be a Sundar, but he may not be a beautiful person. So, what is there in the name? But here, what I have said, laughter is for all the ages. What is there in the name may not be there in the person. Here, for the laughter, whatever is application on a smallest child to the highest child, it will be almost the same. It may differ according to your work, according to your profession, according to the type of your working, according to your, suppose if a student, it will be a different way. If a sports person, it will be a different way. If it is a lady, it will be a different way. But it is a one unique medicine which will work for every individual. And this work only on the human being. You must have found that no animal laugh. No birds laugh. No other creature laugh except the human being. And you are not to learn from anyone. It is a God-given wonderful gift to every individual. The moment you are born, you get this gift now. No parents have taught to the children. Laugh or a smile and a cry is a God-given gift to every human being. You try to observe a 2 months child. They smile 300 times a day and without a reason. And even in the sleep. And when they do it in the sleep, there will be a curiosity among every members of the family. They gather all of them and try to see the child. Even in the sleep, child is smiling. And you must have come across this type of instances time and again. And if not, try to observe this in your family or in the neighborhood, wherever there is a small child. And child used to cry with the reasons. If clothes are wet, if the child is hungry, if they have to draw the attention of the parents, child will cry. But for the smile and the laughter, there were absolutely no reasons. And they were doing as many as more than 300 times. And it's a God-given wonderful gift to all the human beings. But as we grow, it diminishes. It reduces. When I was studying, I started schooling at the age of 6 or 7, so as you must be, correct? And but today's time, even at the age of 1.5 year child, they have to go for the school, play school, they have to go at the fixed time, they have to learn so many things, they have to get up according to the school timing. So the stress, what was starting at the age of 7, now starts at the age of 1.5. They have to appear for the interview. And believe me, they have to learn so many languages at such age. If a child is Gujarati, the spoken language in the house will be the Gujarati. But whereas they have to go in the English medium school. And many a time, the maid servant may be a Maharashtrian or any other community. So the third language. So 3 languages at a time, child is a confused child. Teacher tells one thing, father tells one thing, maid servant tells something else. So at the tiny age, the stress starts accumulating. And from that particular age, 1.5 years child, if a child laughs in the class loudly, the teacher will stop. Hey, what are you laughing? Same thing in the family. Family members also, the father, mother, everyone will say, hey, don't do it thus. So it is being stopped. There is no freedom to the child. And that many a time make anxiety, the child become rebellion, they don't obey the parents. They will do exactly opposite to what the parents wanted. And this is the scenario of practically every family. We do not know. We have to go in a mainstream, and because of the mainstream, the child is a sufferer. We try to imitate, we try to follow what the society do it around. And as a result, the child is a victim. Child is a victim at a tiny age. And what was not there at about 35 years before. 35, 40 years before, we used to be doing the schooling, and that too also in the mother tongue. I learned in Gujarati up to 11th. And then those days, 11th was the thing, and not the 10th. And then went to the college and picked up the English. It is not that key, only the English has to be learned. But here the scenario, whether the family members are educated or not, they will try to put them in the English medium school for the mainstream. And as a result, even at the smallest stage, the child has to undergo the tuitions, which is a killing thing. You don't give them a freedom. You try to impose upon your thoughts and idea what the child has to learn it. So this gives the stress. So I'm talking about the stress part of it, and this become how it becomes a medicine, I'll tell you later on. The moment the child grows, it diminishes. And by the time the child, I'm not telling you the stages, every stage what happened, how it reduced, what did reduce. Because the child has to learn more languages, more subjects, longer duration, tuitions, extracurricular activities, and everything. And as a result, you must have seen, you hardly find children playing in the compound. During our days, we used to be in the compound the moment we have come from the school, and we used to play our games, we used to play our sport, we used to assemble, we used to run around. So hardly child comes in the compound to play a game. They may be sitting in the front of the TV, and as a result, the obesity, even the specs, many children, they have got a spectacles at the tiny age. But these are the reasons. And it has been found that at least 10% of the child, they have got even a pressure at this age. And it is the World Health Organization, the reports are there. It is not my report. So these are all alarming things, you know, but we are not awakened. We want a child to be remain in front of us. We do not want child to go out. The moment a child goes out, we will shout at him. But if he sees the TV in the front of the, in the house itself, or if we play a video game, we do not mind. And when they see this, when they do act this, they try to eat the junk food. So they have proper no nourishment. Habits are not good. Going out, suppose if you are on the third floor, lift is not working, child will refuse to go down. If he climbs three story, he will feel breathless because he has not done those things enough. So these are the reasons. These are the reasons. And believe me, by the time the child passed the 12th standard, the 300 become 10. 10. And by the time the child become graduate, at the age of 20, 21, or postgraduate, it become 3. So in a 21 years time, your 300 become a 3. And in today's time, most of the diseases are psychosomatic. It is on account of the stress, tension, depression. I was talking to one renowned doctor. I told him 90%. He said, no, 90%. It is 95%. You visit any hospital, BP, sugar, arthritis, spondylitis, slip disc, insomnia, allergy, Parkinson, AIDS, cancer, all these are the result of the stress. And stress, you cannot avoid it. Stress is bound to be there. It need not be of the money. It need not be of the possession. It need not be of the family. It may be of the anything. Traveling. Non-obedient children. The neighbors are not good. At the workplace, other colleagues are not all right. You may earn money, but the moment anything, what you may not like, will result into the stress. I'll narrate you one thing. There are 60,000 thoughts in a day. Means every 1.5 seconds there is a one thought. And thought which material, it may not result into the stress. The thought